Hey everybody, this is 22 Tiger Dude wearing my badass tiger shirt, and I'm here to review the Futurama episode Leela and the Genestalk. Alright, so this Futurama episode is when Leela discovers she's starting to get these tentacles on her hand. She's growing tentacles, and like as the episode is progressing, her tentacles are just growing more and more on her, to the point where it's just all over her body, and she doesn't have a normal human body anymore. One day, Leela felt like her tentacles growing more and more was gonna affect the Planet Express crew, so Leela decides to run away. And then Fry, he got these two beans from this dude, so he brought home the beans, and then everyone got mad at Fry because, of course, he bought the beans and he thinks he's an idiot, which was pretty funny. And they didn't even know it was magic, but Fry threw the beans out of the Planet Express outside, and then it starts to grow. So it turns out the beans are magic. Obviously, it does a reference of Jack and the Beanstalk. So you see it growing. When Leela runs away, she climbs on the beanstalk or genestalk, whatever you want to call it, all the way up to the sky. But this episode, I loved it. This is one of the best episodes of season 7, in my humble opinion. I just think this episode is just so well written. The episode has some good humor. I will be honest, a lot of the humor in this episode is a miss in my opinion though. But that doesn't affect my score or anything because of how much I loved the episode overall. Just how amazing, enjoyable it was in terms of storytelling. How well paced it was, how well executed and well edited it was. And as long as that episode could do that, I'm happy. There's heart in this episode, and it's just really sweet how Fry still loves Leela, even though she has tentacles all over her body now. Leela feels like she's the ugliest creature on Earth. This episode makes a few references here that I thought were very clever. Of course, one of them being the Jack and the Beanstalk reference. I thought that was a very clever reference. They referenced Rapunzel, which I really enjoyed. And there's a couple of more. Oh my gosh. There is like a cameo from a show.
What time is it?
Time for you to shut up!
I'll be honest though, I hate Adventure Time. I can't stand Adventure Time. But the 3-second cameo in this episode was just so damn hilarious. One, it was unexpected, it was random, and I just thought it was handled so well. Plus the fact that John DiMaggio is the voice actor for Bender in Futurama and the dog named Jake in Adventure Time. He's the voice actor for both of those shows. And that's why I also really enjoyed that 3-second cameo, because of how clever that was in my opinion. Also, what Mom, aka Carol, was doing up in the sky, I'm not going to spoil what she was doing or what her plan was, but I thought it was a really interesting plan. Overall, I'm just impressed with this episode. Some funny moments, even though a lot of the humor does miss here, in my opinion. But overall, I think the storyline's fantastic. I think the characters are fantastic. We get a nice sense of depth with the characters. Interesting elements. It just keeps you highly entertained all the way through. And I love this episode. I am giving it a 10 out of 10. Freaking amazing. I just loved it all around. Really hits it. Boom. Subscribe, like, and share. Follow me on Facebook, on Twitter. Comment your opinion on this Futurama episode. Don't forget that I will always have Tiger Power!